In this tutorial, we are going to see how we can use Wit.ai's natural language processing capabilities in Elixir for creating bots. After signing up for Wit.ai and creating an application, create a story. Stories are simply the conversations you think your users will have with your bot. The user will ask the bot about the weather of a particular location. We extract the location information and store it in the context. Then the bot should execute fetch weather action to get the temperature. Once we get the temperature, the bot will reply back to the user with the temperature of that location. And at the end, we execute the story ended action. We will use the Echo Phoenix Microsoft bot project as the bootstrap project. Clone the project, get its dependencies, and then compile. Now open the mix.exs file to add new dependencies. Add Elixir Wit dependency to call the Wit APIs. Also add HTTP potion and poison. We will use them to make requests to the weather APIs. Edit messages_controller.ex. Remove all the functions in it except the message received function. First, create the getWitAccessToken function in which we retrieve the WitAccessToken from our config, as this is required to authorize calls to Wit API. In messageReceive function, we will call Wit APIs in a new process. In that process, we create a context which has information about the message that we will need later on to reply back to the user. Then we will call wit.runActions from Elixir Wit library. We pass in the access token, session ID, the module that implements the actions, text received from the user, context, and the maximum number of times the API will be called. We will return back 200 response from the message received function. Now create a new module, weather conversation action. In this module, we have to define the default actions required by the library and the custom actions that were in your story. First, define the save function, which takes the session ID, context, and the response from Wit as parameters. This function is called when Wit wants the bot to reply back to the user. Here we get the relevant values from the context that we added in message controller. And then we will call the Microsoft bot framework client to send message to the user. We create the getBotAuthData function to get the app ID and app secret, which is required for authorizing the request to Microsoft bot APIs. Then we add the second action, which is the merge action. This is called when Wit has extracted information from the text and wants you to merge it in the context. Here we get the location information, add it to the context, and return the updated context from the function. The last required function is the error function, which is called when there is an error in running actions. You can define custom action using def action macro. We will use this to define the fetch weather action. In this function, we get the location from context that we previously added and then call the weather API. We convert the weather to Fahrenheit and return back the updated context. Lastly, we define the story ended custom action and just log it. Now we define the weather client module in which we create the getWeather function, which calls the open weather map APIs to retrieve weather information. The last thing is to add Wit access token and open weather map app ID in our config. As we are going to deploy to Heroku, so we get those values from the environment variables that we set using Heroku dashboard. Let's just compile and deploy to Heroku. Here is the end result. When we ask our bot about the weather in London, it extracts the location information and replies back with the weather. Even if we ask about weather in slightly different way, Wit is smart enough to know that the user intent is to ask about weather. Thank you for watching the screencast.